everyone, in this tutorial I am going to talk how we can convert a float number to a string, and in opposite way, string conversion of string to float or decimal or double or integer is available in studio.h, but to convert a float to a string, it is very important to know. For this, I have declared two functions, one which is calculating the number of decimals in our float number, and the second one is the conversion of our float number and put it in a string, which is an array of characters. In the main function, I have declared the variable float t, and I have declared the character string s, with and I have initialized with only default, and I have asked the user to put a float decimal, and I scan it with the float format and put it in our float variable, and then I call to the function f2a, and our float number and put it on our string variable, and at last I am going to print it out to see the result. What is happening in our counting of the number of decimals? We have our number, and we have a counter, and the result, I have declared the result integer and the initialized with 1, and while that count is not 0, then we are going to multiply the result with the number and put it in the result. And in each loop, in each step of while, I have directly incremented the count. And in the conversion, I have defined a few integers, and I have defined them long because it must match with the items of bits in the float, and I have declared the float number also. And sign, I have initialized with -1, and I am checking if our float number is negative value. Sign must be negative, and because sign is long integer, that character is going to get the integer value, and we are going to make the our negative float as positive, and I am going to put the whole float after this if, whole float in our float, and I am going to put f in an integer, which is going to take the integer part in number, and I initialize both length as 0, and the first length is the decimal part and the second is the integer part. And I am going to calculate the decimal part, and I am going to use the number, which is a float, minus its integer. If it is not 0, it means that we have decimals. And if number minus the float conversion of number is not less than 0, it is not negative, then you are going to put the number 2 equal f multiplied people by the item of its decimal, and I am going to put the number as that number, and I am going to increment the length of decimals with the one or after each step in the loop. And after that we are going to use a for loop, and our for loop variable is length equals starts with if f is bigger than 1, then length is 1, otherwise it is 0, otherwise is 1, and the while loop is going on while f is bigger than 1, and each step we increment with 1, and we are going to put f equals f divided by 10, and it's going and going. It's calculated the decimal part. And in position, we are going to put that length we have it after the for loop, and we are going to put length is equal length plus 1 plus the decimal part, and we are going to put the number equal the number, and if the sign up here we check, if it is negative then make the length plus plus and position plus plus, and after if not only start a loop, start from length, and while I is bigger than equal 0 and I minus minus. If I is equal length, ri is the null pointer, zero pointer, which is the end of the string. Else, if I is position, you are going to put that decimal sign, and else if sign is negative and I is zero, put negative sign. Else you are going to put each number in your array of character. Okay, now we run this. This is okay. I am running and I am going to use 19.7, and it is 19.7 up here. Run it again. I am going to use minus 19.734, and it is minus 119.734, and it is the same. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.